Today I'm going to talk about what I will do with unlimited resources. So I'm going to make organic products affordable for everyone, and I'm doing this because according to how stuff works, which is as I remember saw earlier, organic foods are more expensive, costing around 10-30% of regular foods. Organic foods are also only available in limited quantities, making them unaffordable for many people. Organic food. The basic thing you need to know about organic food is that you need to know what it is. Vegetables, meat, fruit, fish, and eggs that are grown naturally without using chemicals are some examples for organic food products. Organic foods are grown without using any chemicals like fertilizers, herbicides, and pesticides. Farmers use these types of chemicals to control various pests and diseases from insects such as mosquitoes, rats, worms, and etc. When growing food organically without using any chemicals, they have to select expensive alternative methods, which makes them expensive. Organic foods are more nutritious, and most of them don't have any chemicals in them, unlike regular foods. Those who are allergic to chemicals eat organic foods. What is the current situation of organic foods? Organic foods are available in 20,000 food stores and are sold in 73% of all the grocery stores worldwide. Why are organic foods more expensive than regular foods? Organic foods are more expensive than regular foods because of how fresh and tasty they are. Grown organic foods contain more land, water, and other resources than growing regular foods. In 2020, around $56.5 billion are used for organic food products. Organic food products rate increases every year by double digits. An estimated around 18.3 million acres are used for organic farming. Liechtenstein, Samoa, and Australia are the top three countries that consume around 25-40% of land for organic farming. What are some solutions for some organic food problems? Most people think organic foods are pesticide free, and if you're one of them, you're wrong. Not all organic foods are pesticide free. Some organic foods have pesticide in them to protect the food from pests and diseases. One of the reasons for using pesticide is to control the weeds. A weed is a kind of a plant that affects the growth of the crop because weeds grow much faster and it takes up a lot of space. How am I going to make organic food products affordable for everyone? So I think the NOP, known as the National Organic Program, should think more deeply about making organic food products affordable for everyone so that they can get a good profit out of it, instead of just selling organic foods at high prices, which attracts less customers. How am I going to grow foods without using any chemicals? So I'm going to achieve this by trying some of the two successful farming methods, which are crop rotation and upgrading. First, we start with crop rotation. A crop rotation is by planting two or more different types of crops near each other. It's by not planting the same exact crop in the same place and switching their places in a rotation every year to avoid having pests and diseases building up in soil. Second, flaming. Flaming is fueled by natural gas, which helps to kill the weeds while doing a little damage to the crops. I believe our ancestors relied on many other various natural methods for organic farming. So I'm going to try to modernize the technique use and make it available for everyone to use. One of the challenges I may face is the lack of manpower to support the farming process. How and why I'm going to decrease the labor shortage? I'm going to do this by finding people who are interested in farming and then train them and then give them the necessary tools and knowledge so that they can get started. I'm doing this because there are only a limited amount of farmers growing organic food. Doing this will increase the overall organic food products, which will pay off for a certain amount of time than before. Finally, in conclusion, doing all this will have a huge impact on people's lives by decreasing hunger. Because this year there has been over 8 to 10 million people who have died by starvation. Thank you. Any questions? Thank you all for listening to my speech. A special thanks to Dr. Chankar for giving me the opportunity and for the motivation.
I can hear his heartbeat now. Now, Iniyan reminds me of all of our typical childhood from Tamil Nadu, right? growing up without even realizing all the potential that we have. So he still has to explore a lot of potential that he has, and it's a great starting point. I'm really impressed with how soon he was able to write the speech and fully understand and able to prepare and research and write and prepare and deliver the speech as well, because he missed roughly half of the classes, right? He had to be in India, he missed half of the class. When he came back, pretty much everyone had their speeches fully written and even practiced it a few times. He barely had a few weeks to prepare. And within that period, he chose a topic that is very close to what we do in India, and prepared, did a lot of research, and delivered it. Great job, Iniyan. Well done.